Hello, buddy. It's Metal Mootel here, and today I've gotten a fun request from YouTube user and for you to see. Yeah, the figure he requested was over the Fusion series Gungan. So yeah. Anyways, so yeah, big shout out to Panda for you to see requesting a third video in my collection. So anyways, let's get into the video. First off, detail. Really, really nice. The head looks good. You can see the sparkles inside of him there. The scales look good. And the scale looks in the chest and the stomach area. Down. Feet look good. Even the wings on his back look good. The tail looks good. Even the bottom of the tail looks good. Yeah, I love the detail on this video. If you look right here, in his skin here, you can see the sparkles in his head, even on his arms, you can also see it on his stomach area too, also on the legs, you can see him on the legs, you can see the sparkles on the legs, also on the bottom of the feet. Now for paint job. Paint job looks nice. And you see his visor is a deep red color. It would almost blur a bit in the movie, but yeah. And it has a little bit of highlights of green. You can see that right there on his beak. His mandibles are nicely painted. Even the mouth is nicely painted. Even the horns on the top of his head and neck are nicely painted. Claws are nicely painted. And the gold paint on the scales are nicely applied. They're really nicely painted. The buzzsaw is nicely painted. Yeah, the buzzsaw is nicely painted. Feet are nicely painted. The wings, nice painted. One minor thing about complaining about this thing, he doesn't have the tips. He doesn't have the tips on him, like the thing on the back of the packaging here. Don't see it. See the thing on the back of the packaging has the tips, but this one doesn't. The spikes on the tail are nicely painted. And the gold paint on the wings are nicely applied. You can see that there. And the, look at the green stripe on his tail, pinned all the way down. And as here, the paint's really nicely applied. Another thing, this finger. He's cast out of a, he's made of a soft, squishy vinyl. You see that here? He's squishy. Yeah, so he's cast out of a squishy, clear vinyl. Now for articulation, the head can rotate 360. Arms rotate 360. Legs rotate 360. And the tail has a glue seal, but you've got it. You can rotate, but it is difficult to rotate 360. last night and I think about how I wanted to do this with you. And now I'm going to show you a side-by-side comparison between the Fusion Series Gaijin and the normal Gaijin with a side-by-side comparison. One thing I'll notice here between the two, they're the exact same mold. But however, as you can see here, the Fusion Gaijin has a more big head, whereas your regular one does not. Whereas the regular Gaijin does not have the head. Yeah, the beak on him is a little fatter as the one on the regular one. A little smaller. And one thing you're gonna notice between the two is the clear translucent plastic on the Fusion Gaijin here. Yeah, even one thing I'm noticing here that the fins on the regular Gaijin are more dark gold on the regular ones. As much brighter gold wings, but yeah. Which does seem to be a little fatter than the regular one. The legs are the same mold, but the shirts and the parts and the tails are the same, but you see the difference here between the tails? You see what I see? The regular show of Gaijin has a much dimmer gold paint, whereas the Fusion Gaijin has a much brighter gold paint. So yeah. And the eyes are the exact same color.
So I want to show you guys a side-by-side comparison between the Fusion Gaijin and the normal Gaijin.
I was going to scaling.
The food creation videos. Let's talk about Bandai creation.
Godzilla 1954.
Yeah, he's got the exact same height.
Yeah, but Gaijin should be a little bigger, about that, right there somewhere.
Yeah, let's get him right here. Now let's scale him with Bandai creations, Godzilla 68. One big problem here. This figure, right here, is way too big. He's way too big. He should be a little smaller than Gaijin. This figure is way too big. Yeah, so he does not fit in scale with Bandai creations, Godzilla 68. Alright, let's try Bandai creations, Hedorah. Again, Hedorah looks a little too big. You know, Hedorah versus Gaijin. Yeah. Let's try Bandai creations, Mechagodzilla. Yeah, these two make a really awesome tag team. Mechagodzilla and Gaijin versus Godzilla and King Caesar. See, he looks good with Mechagodzilla. Let's try Bandai creations,
King Caesar. Yeah, what do you guys think? He looks okay with him. So yeah, let's get him.
Well, now let's get him a little pink tag. Godzilla 1954.
Again, he should be a little bigger. Well, look at this. The pink tag, Godzilla 1954, it's in scale with your Bandai creations Fusion Gaijin.
Now let's try purple tag,
Godzilla 68. Now look at this. Look at this. This is an excellent scaling here. Now these two figures are in good scale with each other. They're in good scale. 6 and 8, the horn spiking looks like getting bigger. So these two are in scale with one another. Nice scaling here.
And finally, the scaling with the normal guy again.
And these two will scale up each other.
Sexy moon, sexy night. Yeah. Now finally, let's take a look at the box. It's the same for now, Beauty Penetration's Boning Godzilla. You know Godzilla's name. One thing is, just the Fusion series. This Fusion series. Inside the box shows Godzilla and Gigan blowing out. See on the other side. Right here. We get a nice shot of Godzilla Final Wars. His name is what it is. On the back of the box, we got Godzilla 68, Godzilla, and Gigan. So, yeah, that is the box. Now, on to Verity. That's what it looks like in the box. No, they're on to Verity. And you can get him on Amazon for about $20, I believe. So, yeah, paint job's good, details nice, articulation's good, scales nice. Yeah, anyways, this was requested by Panda from ATC. For the figure he requested, he gets a thumbs up. So, you guys, this was Battle Muto, signing out.